Good afternoon. Can I remind members that social distancing measures are in place in the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus? And I ask that members take care to observe these measures, including when entering and exiting the Chamber. And please only use the aisles and walkways to access your seat and when moving around the Chamber. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. Our time for reflection leader today is Linda Britton, celebrant, Humanist Society Scotland.
Presiding Officer, thank you for inviting me to speak today at Time for Reflection. We should all know what that means, but do we take time to reflect? Some of us have busy lives, get caught up in what we feel is important without thinking of that what we do and say has an effect on others. As a humanist, I try to treat people as I expect them to treat me, to think before I act or speak, and just recently had to make a decision that I thought might upset someone. So why did I do it? And importantly, how? I engaged with the person, asked them to talk to me about their reasons, then asked them to listen to mine. We had a middle ground. Both of us felt listened to and respected for our different beliefs. I was able to conduct the ceremony for a person who did not have a faith, and their next of kin was able to lead the mourners in prayer after the ceremony closed. This was important to them. It was the right thing to do and benefited everyone. There is much debate in this chamber, rightly so. Our actions and words cause reaction in others. When we think before we speak, encourage discussion, try to walk in another's shoes, we become human beings that care. And as the people who have been elected to make decisions, it's important that this is foremost in your minds. If nothing else, the pandemic has shown us what is important. Look at Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Everyone needs a place to sleep, food, and to feel safe. As a human being, it's my responsibility and yours to work together to ensure no one is left without these basic needs. As John Donne wrote, no man is an island, and the pandemic has shown us that. And with COP26 taking place soon in Scotland, we can make changes that benefit all living creatures. We've lived through the worst year and a half that most of us can remember. I hope you've taken heart from the many people that have worked throughout without a thought for themselves. We applaud them. We can do better. We can show our gratitude by changing our behaviour, or as I mentioned at the beginning, reflecting on what we do and how we do it. Thank you for listening. It's been a privilege to speak to you.
Thank you. It's so enjoyable.